am so excited because today I am vlogging, as you can tell. I don't know how many days this vlog is going to contain. I don't know. But I am just like, I haven't done this in, I think I checked the other day and the last time that I vlogged was the Luna vlog. When we got her when she was a puppy, and that was about 6 months ago. So it's been a while and I'm really excited, and I'm excited to actually notice myself how my day-to-day life has shifted, and also to share that with you. I was thinking to myself the other day that one of the first thoughts that I actually had when I became aware of the online coaching community and the online like mentorship community and spiritual community in general was that all these people were sharing and teaching about lifestyles, right? They were teaching about healthy lifestyles full of inner peace, and they were sharing how they live, right? But no one was doing daily vlogs, or no one was doing any vlogs. So even though you could hear them talk about how they live, and not many people were actually showing it and kind of taking their followers through like an actual day, and how, because you can talk about concepts and you can talk about, oh, daily routines are great and things like that. You could talk about different concepts that you use to uplift your own life in the day-to-day experience, but I feel like it hits so much different when you actually see the person doing it and you see the types of kind of like ups and downs that happen as you embrace more of a peaceful lifestyle. So yeah, that is my intention with these vlogs. Also, my intention is obviously I just am excited to get back into vlogging because that is something that I started with and I kind of miss it. I'm also curious to see how I've changed, because like in terms of how I vlog, because I used to be very like nervous about it, and I used to be very like anxious about whether the vlog that I was making was coming out good. So if I was doing a weekly vlog, for example, every time I would pick up the camera and put it down, I'd be like, okay, my mind would try to go through all the clips that had already been recorded and try to figure out if it would make a good vlog, which is like dumb and a waste of time, because like, why do you need to do that? Once you're in the editor suite, you can figure all that stuff out. But anyway, and also it doesn't matter, so I'm excited to see. But anyway, right now what we're doing is, let me show you. So this is Luna. Hi, she's quite big. So I've got my laptop set up there, and I've got that tangle of wires is a new lav mic that I got, and I'm starting off today, I mean it's the afternoon, 1 p.m. I'm starting off today with a live stream on my Patreon. For those of you that don't know, I have a Patreon now, so if you look in the description box below, you'll see a link to it, and one of the things that I do is a weekly life update live stream. So I basically just go live and allow anyone who's on there to interact with me. Also, the replays are always available, but essentially I just go live and I kind of talk through the past week that I just had. Oh, there's a cardinal outside. That's so cute. Really quickly, cardinals are very symbolic to me. And also we just had this conversation in one of the group containers that I'm in with my friend G. It's called the Illumination Container, and it's all about spiritual growth. And one of the things we just talked about this past Saturday was cardinals. But anyway, it's cute that it came up. But anyway, what was I saying? I was saying that I go live every single week, and I talk about what happened during that week. I reflect on it, I process it, and you get to see me do that in real time. So if that's interesting to you, you can just join the Patreon. Any live streams that you've missed, you will be able to watch the replays, and any ones that are upcoming, you'll be able to engage live. So yay, so exciting. This is what Luna looks like now. Luna. She blink. Let's see if we can get a small. Oh, there she is. Hello. Sorry, you're a vlog dog. I think you forgot. There you go. What a cutie. Thank you for blessing our vlog today, Luna. We love you. Hi. So I finished the live stream. It went really well. I love watching it back because going into the live streams especially, I have no idea what's gonna come out of my mouth. And so afterwards when I'm done, I always sit and watch it so I could title it. And I'm always like so inspired by what I said because I'm just like, whoa, how did that come out of me? So it's just, I love it. So anyway, I just did that and now I am going to go to my desk. I've just been chilling. We've just been chilling on the couch, right, Luna? Look. Hi. So we've just been chilling on this couch doing that. So I'm gonna go back to my desk and see what else I have to do today. Today's Monday. So Mondays, I usually get my week in order. So I kind of know what's happening. And so I'm all caught up. But yeah, let's do that. Oh, one last thing that I feel called to share in this living room is every time I do a client call or anytime I sit down to do some sort of focused work, I like having a candle. So some of the candles that I have, actually these ones have intentions written out on them. This one says, come on, focus, confidence and freedom. And this one I just bought. It smells like men. So I call this my divine masculine candle. And I always light this because it's confidence and freedom. I always light it when I'm doing a client call or when I'm doing a live stream or even a video. So anything where I want to draw in on the energy of confidence and freedom, I light it. And that helps me set the space and the intention. So that's the fun thing that I've been doing. I have another one called Reflection and Clarity from the same brand. So I do that kind of when I'm meditating or I'm doing a journaling thing or something like that. And then now I'm gonna start getting more blank ones and putting my own intentions onto them. But these ones, they're nice too.
Hello.
How's it going?
It's going good.
Do you want to share?
We're working.
Oh.
Hello.
She's a cute one.
Oh, yes.
Look at her tail.
Hey, don't eat me. Don't eat me. I'll eat you.
Ah. Scoochin'.
Dance, dance, dance.
Ow. No.
Do you have anything to share with the world?
Nice day today. Actually, it's a little cold, but it's nice. It's sunny.
Yeah.
And I'm just working.
Okay, so that's done. Luna's trying to eat my snacks. I got a banana, strawberry, chocolate milkshake. It's got banana, strawberry, chocolate, no, cacao powder, but like just the regular grocery store cacao powder, not ceremonial cacao, and milk and almond butter. That's in that. And then I also have cheese and crackers because I'm gonna make a dinner today. I think I'm gonna cook pasta, so I don't really need a lot right now since it's 4:30 p.m. and this is the first thing that I'm really eating today. Garrett's in the background sipping his he's so lucky that I'm making him some milkshakes. So my eating schedule is still, we wake up really late. Like I think I woke up at 12 today. We stay up late too. So I didn't eat anything until now. I'm gonna eat this and then gonna eat dinner a couple hours from now. But I just wanted to show you what I did. So I responded to a bunch of messages that I had and emails and stuff. And Luna is trying to get some crackers. But one thing that I started doing is, I've got some dead roses here, that's fine. I just have a little sticky note paper thing on my desk that kind of outline the main events of each day. That's not everything that I'll be doing that day, but those are the things that I'm kind of holding myself responsible to. It just helps me, like, as I have more clients and more timed commitments, it helps me make sure that I know what's going on. So yeah, so I'm gonna do that, and then for the rest of the day I'm kind of done in terms of what I was planning to do today, so the rest of the day is free flow. So this is what I've got for dinner today. It's just roasted veggies. So I've got some zucchini, broccolini, some red bell pepper, some spicy peppers, and some carrots. I just roasted them and put them on in a sauce that was already pre-made. I'm eating dinner alone today because I don't think Garrett feels like eating dinner. I think that's what he said. I just wanted to share one thing. I don't think I'm gonna vlog after. Is that good? Okay, yeah, you know what, I'll share it another time. I'm just gonna see you tomorrow, probably. Bye!
Hello, Luna! Oh, cheeky, cheeky, cheeky. Cheeky, cheeky, cheeky. And then she, oh! Ooh, she wants to jump. Luna still sleeps in her crate, so in the morning, she gets so excited and she always wants to say hi to us. And then, like, once she's done that, then she ignores us for the rest of the day. Aw, Scoochie. You're so cute. Oh, I can't even see you. Oh, what a cutie.
Good morning. So the first thing that Luna does when she wakes up is
she has to go for a pee and a poop.
And since we live in an apartment, she has to, we actually have to take her all the way outside. Oh no. She walks down the stairs. She's still pulley. That's okay. So she wants to go run in that field. Will we let her? Okay, now you're sitting. Wait, come back. Sit. Oh, sit. Okay. Oh, sorry. Much as I can get sunlight. So I'm gonna tweeze my eyebrows, and I haven't gotten my eyebrows done in lots of years, probably like more than 10 years, because whenever I'd get my eyebrows done by someone else, they would always do it in a way I really hated. So I just started doing it myself, but I don't do them on a schedule or anything. But whenever I notice that my face, I just, like, there's something off about how my face looks, I'm like, oh, it's probably the eyebrows, let me go do that. But I just wanted to talk about how this vlogging thing, oh my goodness, like I didn't anticipate how much like mental chatter it was going to create for me. It's almost like yesterday during my live stream, I was talking about how I've been really trying to commit to staying in the present moment because my mind at the moment, it likes to live in the future because it likes to plan out what it's doing next. And the vlogging thing is like really challenging this aspect of me because when you vlog or when I vlog, my mind is constantly trying to plan next shots, you know? So for example, I woke up in the morning and one of the first automatic thoughts that I had was, oh, what should we do today? Like what did, like we have to do things that we didn't do in the vlog yesterday. Like it's just doing that. But what I really want to make sure this vlog is an authentic expression, just like a documentation of what I'm doing. I don't want to do things because I'm vlogging. I want to do things and then just vlog them if I feel called to. Like I want it to be very like in the flow. I don't want to be trying to manipulate all these like videos in my mind and clips and try to see how the storyline's gonna go. Like anyway, it's a fun, interesting and difficult process right now, but we're just gonna keep going because when things like this happen, the more that you expose yourself and the more comfortable you get with the discomfort, the quicker it dissolves and doesn't become a problem anymore. Oh, another thing that I wanted to talk about was my morning routine has been shifting recently because for a while I was really doing the whole like, this is what I do every day. But as I kind of stabilized that, I realized that different days require different things. So some days I really, really, really need to stretch. And today's one of those days. So I'm gonna do that later. But other days, I don't really want to stretch and my body isn't really telling me to stretch, so I realize that there's discrepancy between what my body actually needs every day. And so once I got used to having a daily routine, then I started letting it flow naturally based on what I was feeling called to do. But one of the things that I always hold is to drink. It's so simple, but I feel like I didn't do it for the longest time, and I'm sure people talk about it, but here's a reminder again, drink water right before you wake up because your body has not had water all night. And so when you wake up and you drink water, it really helps you stay awake, to be honest. I feel like I can get very sleepy and fatigued if I don't drink water right away. So drink water in a wine glass to make you feel fancy. I'm gonna eyebrow from now. So the new way that I do yoga, actually sometimes I still follow yoga videos, but most of the time when I'm stretching now, it is a conversation between me and my body. So I basically just put music on in headphones or not, mostly headphones though, because I have noise cancellation, so it like really puts me in this like other space. And I just move with the music, and whatever I feel called to stretch, I stretch that part. And the only thing I set a timer sometimes, so I'm like, okay, I want to do this for 20 minutes, just because I oftentimes find like sometimes I just want to like rush it, or sometimes I just want to like end early when I'm not actually fully feeling complete. So setting a timer as the only structure really helps. Okay, so now that we've got our dance break in, that has been so life-changing, I swear. Oh, my hair's all messed up. My hair is giving me problems today. So if you see me fiddling with it, it's because I'm feeling really like insecure about it. So I'm just gonna, whatever. But dancing has been so life-changing because it's like the one way that you can really move the energy around. Any trapped energy in any part of your body that is feeling like stuck or just like tense, if you dance it out, it's literally gone. And I just, anytime I'm feeling lower, I do I just put headphones on, listen to music, and just move. Not every day I'm dancing, like jumping around, and it's super high energy. Some days it's literally just like very slow, and that works too. It's just like I keep saying, it's so important to tune in to each moment and ask your body what it wants. Ask your body what it needs. And this, I just wanted to sit on the sofa, but I was in the kitchen earlier because I'm going to make some cacao for myself now. And for a while I was drinking cacao every day, and then I realized that I was almost getting reliant on it. So then I went like a week without it at all, and I dealt with like those feelings of like, oh, I need it. Oh no, I'm feeling emotionally low, I need it. Oh, I'm feeling tired, I need it. And I sat through those and processed them, and I didn't let myself have it. And then now the attachment to it is so much less, and I don't drink it every day now, but I ask my body, do you want cacao today? And sometimes it says yes, and sometimes it says no. Sometimes it just wants water, sometimes it wants tea, sometimes it just wants to have a meal. So today is cacao. And then later after that, I'm going to be filming Q&A number 3, which should be up before, like by when you're watching this, it should already be on my channel. So we're gonna do that today, and then that's kind of all I've scheduled for today. So we'll see what the rest of the day does. And Luna is eating some socks. Also, we've got our like jungle over here because Luna likes to dig in the soil. She's so cute. She literally just keeps herself occupied, and when she gets bored, she'll come and try to bite us to get our attention. For the most part, she does her own thing or sleeps. Right, Luna? Oh, something funny that she does is we have these like footstools, and she'll take that ball and she'll roll it under the footstool on one side and then push it. See, oh, she's doing it now. And then it comes out the other side and she like plays with it like that. It's this whole game that she's created on her own. Right, Luna? Hee hee, Gigi. I can't get over her. Here she is. Oh, actually, let's see if she can do this. So I want her to get her ducky. It's over there. Can you go bring your ducky? Where's your ducky? We've been trying to teach her her toys. Where's your ducky? Go bring it. Good girl. That is your ducky.
Hi. I just wanted to quickly interrupt this vlog to inform you that I have opened the digital doors, I really like that phrase, to my first live group course, Goddess Initiation. It's gonna be an 8-week course. We meet twice a week. I teach you things, we talk about things. It's just gonna be really fun. If you're curious about it at all or intrigued, check out the link in my bio, in my description box below, to see all the details. And if it's something that is calling out to you, go ahead and submit an application form, and then we'll get on a discovery call, and it'll just be fun from there. So if this speaks to you, then please go check it out. But yeah, back to the vlog. Hello, welcome to Wednesday. It is late tonight. I think it's about 10 or 11 p.m. I felt like today was a very like
laid back kind of day. So I didn't want to vlog, and so I didn't, because I have the freedom to do that. So it was actually really quite productive though, because I started off, I started off the day with a discovery call, and I actually have a new one-on-one client, so that's really exciting. And then since Garrett and I pretty much stayed up till like 3 a.m. last night, and I had a call at 11 a.m., I was like sleepy, so I took it kind of slow today. I took Luna out. I got myself new flowers to replace the dead roses that were on my desk. And I'm making cookies right now. So I'll probably show you a shot of the cookies, and then I'll see you tomorrow. And Luna, come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. And Luna. Oh yeah, I took her to the dog park today, but I didn't bring my camera because I didn't wanna. She's still got a biting habit, but on the bright side, she really understands how much pressure to use. So when she bites, it doesn't hurt. It's more annoying than anything. But yeah. She's such a bobo. Okay.
So they're not like the most beautiful. I mean, they're still, look how round that one is. It's pretty good. I'm too freaking lazy to, I don't know, make it look really plate it, make it look super fancy. So there you are. I told you I was gonna show you my cookies, and I showed up to what I promised. So I'll do a close up to end the day. And yeah.
Just slowly bring your hips towards your feet. You can bring your forehead on the ground. Take two breaths here.
Welcome to Thursday. Today is a very sleepy day. It's very rainy out, and I am being called to just take the first couple of hours that I'm awake today. I meditate a lot now, and some days just require me to just sit in a more of a meditative state for a longer period of time, and today's one of those days. And I don't necessarily always meditate like this, you know. Sometimes, a lot of the time actually, I really like meditating with cacao, so just being really, really mindful and conscious as I'm consuming it. But another thing that I'm doing today is I am feeling called to read. So this is the second time that I'm rereading this book, The Sophia Code. And if you feel a resonance with this, and if you feel any sort of drawing in towards it, I highly recommend that you follow it, because I don't even can really consider this a book. It's very transformative, and it's transformative on levels that we as human beings don't even fully comprehend yet. And I first started reading it in last November, and I was like expecting to start reading it as I read other books, like just going through from beginning to end. But as I read it, I realized that there needed to be integration periods in between chapters and in between sections. And so it actually took me November, December, January, and February, I think, it took me 4 months to get through the first read through, because it's a spiritual text. and it requires some time after you kind of receive the information and the light codes within this to, it takes some time to absorb and integrate them. And it's kind of crazy because this book is one of the things that really made it evident to me how much our inner world is connected to our external world. You know how I always say that our external world is a reflection of our internal state. So I would like read part of this, pick up some concepts, and then it would just immediately, I would notice it being rippled out into my reality. And it has just really changed the way that I understand information and how I understand how information affects us and how every single piece of information is a code, and we can choose to install the code or we can choose to not even like just delete it, but depending on our choice, it really affects the way that we perceive and exist in this world. So I just wanted to talk a little bit about that. I'm being called to read Key Code 1 today, Isis. And the first time I read through it in my mind, but this time I'm going to be reading it out loud. And last time I tried to read, for those of you who have read this, last time I tried to read the first read through, I tried to read Key Code 2, the Hathor initiation out loud, and I literally couldn't get through it because I was just like coughing. I don't know what it was, but I think it was just, there was so much higher dimensional information coming through that my physical body just literally could not handle it. And so the guidance I got for the first read through was just read it in your mind and it'll do what it needs to do. And then on the second read through, you can try reading it again out loud and see if your physical body is in the state to handle that energy. So yeah, that's what I'm doing. Isis is the first Key Code mentor. So I'm really excited to read it out loud and experience that. But yeah, today's very slow. I don't think I'm going to be doing much today. I might be editing a video. I don't know. I really tune in, like I keep saying this vlog, I tune in each moment to what I'm going to be doing. So even though I had that weekly plan that you saw earlier, even though I have that weekly plan, that structure is not rigid, and I always override that structure that I created with my mental self, my ego, and I override it with what I feel in every moment. So even though yesterday I was supposed to finish editing a video and posting it, but I just didn't feel called to. And today, I don't know if it's going to happen or not, but what has really felt true to me is that whenever it's meant to happen, like if you really truly follow your inner guidance in every moment, you kind of align yourself with your most harmonious path, the path that is like what I always call the divine flow. And when you align yourself with the divine flow, things become very, very easy and very fluid. And oftentimes, many of us don't have any experience with aligning with divine flow because we are conditioned to try so hard to get ourselves out of it. Like, we don't trust it. Many of us don't even believe that it's a force that exists in the world. So when we take ourselves off, like, we come into difficulties and we come into modes of suffering and things like that. But once you really learn how to tune into yourself and you really learn how to trust that the guidance that you're receiving in each moment is the guidance that is the best, it becomes like, it feels like you're floating through life. There's literally like everything just comes together perfectly, and you can notice that it's doing that. And any challenges or obstacles that come up, because you have instilled and practiced cultivating a deep sense of faith and trust, over time you notice that those obstacles and challenges, they automatically work themselves out. So yeah, today is a chill day. All I know what I'm doing today is that I'm going to be reading this book and sitting here for a little bit, and then after that, who knows? But I also don't feel called to vlog more now. I feel like this is a good conclusion to this vlog. I have no idea how long it is. It's probably long. But I hope you enjoy the longer session, like the fact that I have longer videos, because I do believe that a lot of my offering is just in my presence. So many people who are in really, really darker states of existence, they have told me that even just having me in the corner of their room as they're doing other stuff, just talking, even if they're rewatching videos, they say that it helps them feel anchored into a more uplifted state of being. So I think for a long time I really struggled with why my videos always came out so long, because I've also gotten a bunch of comments about how long my videos are, and traditionally most YouTubers don't have such long videos, but I've always felt inclined to make long videos, and I think that's one of the reasons now I'm receiving more clarity about that, and about how, because it doesn't really matter what I'm doing or what I'm saying exactly, it's more just me offering my energy and my presence to you, and for you to be able to access that at any time that you have internet. So yeah, thank you for being here. Thank you for watching this vlog. I hope you enjoyed it. I will see you in the next video, or in a previous video, because time on my YouTube channel also doesn't exist. So you could go hang out with 2017 version of me if you wanted to. How crazy is that? Okay. Bye. Say bye, Luna. Say bye, Luna. Okay. Love you.